When patients with anxiety and depression come to the clinic, we offer two very good treatments for them. One is a medication called selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors called SSRIs. Another is cognitive behavioral therapy, a kind of talk therapy. The issue is that both of these take a long time to work, so patients have to wait 3 to 6 months before they actually see whether they are getting an effect in reducing their depression and anxiety symptoms from the treatment. The dilemma that we have for patients and for clinicians is that we don't have any way to guide a patient to one treatment versus another. This is important because both treatments are effective, but they're equally effective. And one is very time intensive and limited. In other words, CBT is not available at all clinics, and SSRIs can come with adverse side effects. So if we could solve this mystery, it'll be very important for resource allocation, but also for patients' time. EEG is a method of measuring brain waves or electrical activity right on the scalp. So a patient can wear it as a cap right in the outpatient clinic. It's very inexpensive. It doesn't take a lot of resources and can be located right in the office setting. The idea is to use neuroscience-based technologies to see whether we can identify markers that we could use to predict a patient's response to one treatment versus the other treatment.
In this study, we were interested in the error-related negativity, or the ERN. In this task, participants see a string of arrows and they're asked to indicate which direction the center arrow is pointing. Is it pointing to the left or is it pointing to the right? And they use a mouse on the computer to indicate that direction. On some of the trials, all of the arrows are congruent, so they're all facing the same direction, but there's others that are more difficult where the arrows are incongruent, and that is to make it a bit more difficult. The task also provides feedback along the way. It says try to go faster, try to be more accurate. And this is a way to speed participants up or to get them questioning their performance, which inherently causes errors. And we can measure the response in the brain when they make that error. We found that a more enhanced ERN, or a more exaggerated neural response to making that mistake, was associated with better outcomes in the talk therapy. This is the task that we use to capture reward responding. The task essentially involves seeing two doors and guessing which door has a prize behind it. The participants can either win or lose money, and they receive feedback after they guess. The brain component that we're interested in tends to be enhanced after those green arrows. So whenever the participant wins money, the brain response becomes enhanced. The more that the reward positivity was blunted at baseline, the better the participant did with SSRIs. As the reward positivity increased, depressive symptoms went down with both treatments. And so what we think is that this reward measure at the brain level can help track symptom improvement for depression.
Well, one of the problems that we have in the clinic these days is that when a patient gets a treatment and they get side effects or they don't feel better, they tend to drop out of treatments. So that ends up being a missed opportunity. Essentially, we lose the opportunity to take care of a patient, and patients ultimately continue to endure with the symptoms of anxiety and depression. What these two studies have highlighted or discovered is that we can use a relatively inexpensive outpatient procedure to help come up with a way to biologically and objectively guide a patient to the right treatment at the right time.